One of these pops is real and one of them is fake. Let's find out which one is the real one and what to watch out for. What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Hope everybody's having a great week. Today, we have a very special video, and beside me, I have two General Grievous pops. One of these guys is real, and one of them is fake. Today, we're going to do a complete breakdown of the General Grievous pop, as there are a lot of fake ones on the market, and we are going to give you guys some tips on what to watch out for you so you don't get scammed. One of my least favorite things in the Funko community is the fact that there are a lot of fakes out there. And when it comes to Star Wars, it's very close to home for me. As you guys know, or if you've seen any of our videos in the past, we are huge Star Wars fans and collectors. And if you are a patron of the channel this month, then you just might find one of these amazing Star Wars pucks in your monthly patron box. And check out a lucky few of you. We'll find our awesome Boba Fett hockey team chase. So, without further ado, let's get into it and let's see which one of these pops is real.
All right, guys, so we're actually gonna use the top-down camera for the first time ever here on Slapshot Pops. We're gonna give you guys the full breakdown of the fake one versus the real one. And for all you experienced collectors, right off the bat, you should be able to tell which one is fake and which one isn't. However, today's video is primarily for people who haven't been in the community for a long time or want to make sure they are not about to purchase a fake General Grievous pop. And looking at both of these pops right away, I mean, you can tell that whoever made the fake did a really good job. And I'll ask you guys right off the bat, can you even tell which one the fake pop is? Well, if you can't, don't worry, because we are gonna break it down. So we're gonna look at the box and then we're gonna compare the inserts, and then we're gonna bust out the figures from both boxes and we're gonna compare them side by side. So right off the bat, the first takeaway that a lot of collectors look for is the bubbles in the top left-hand corner of the box. And as you can see, that is not an issue here. Both of these boxes actually have the bubbles. So you can see that whoever created it did a great job copying and pasting. Another thing collectors tend to look for a lot is the sticker. And both of these stickers look pretty accurate. So we could legit have two actual Walgreens stickers here. And another thing that a lot of collectors, you know, they like to see, can I see through the sticker? If I can see through the sticker, then that's an easy layup. But you can actually see through the sticker in both of these pops. So how can I tell which one is fake and which one is real? Well, a huge giveaway, at least for this pop. And if you guys haven't figured it out by now, it is this one, the one in my right hand. And look at this, guys. We are missing a huge chunk in the face insert right here on the front of the box. So as you can see in the real one, we have one cutout here and then the clear distinction between his lightsaber and the side of his face. Whereas here we only have the distinction here, which should be a little bit more noticeable, but we definitely don't have this huge square cutout right here. So that is the first red flag right off the bat. Now, if you look at the pop even a little more, you can kind of see in the box that the head placement is not the same. And we're going to go through that in a little bit later on in the video and show you exactly what I mean by that. And the last thing that I noticed right off the bat is just look at the size of General Grievous's face here. If you can tell, if you can look at the box, it is a smidge bigger compared to over here, the sizing we have on this box. So moving into the rest of the box, we're gonna flip it on the other side here. Whoever made this fake, they did a very, very good job. And to the non-experienced collector, you might be paying a small fortune for a pop that is not legit. I mean, guys, look at this side-by-side view. I mean, they got everything from Qui-Gon here, who is the correct pop in the line. Everything is correct in terms of the font size. They even got the trademark logo correct. I mean, everything, the registered R right underneath the pop logo, everything on the back is looking great. Now, When we flip it on over to the right side here, we do have another red flag that we have to look at. And you guys can probably tell, look at the size of the General Grievous name font here compared to the General Grievous over here. We do have a little bit of size differential, and right there is another key giveaway. It's very small, so you know, unless you're a experienced collector with a trained eye, you are not gonna see that right off the bat. So that's the box. Now it's time to bust the figure out and compare side by side, see what else we can find to see if this is actually a fake pop.
All right, so here we go. We got both General Grievouses out of their box. And before we get into what's different about both these figures, I just want to point out something with the inserts that I feel like not a lot of collectors talk about or mention when identifying fake pops. This is the real insert straight from Funko. And this is the fake one. Now, if you can tell, it's a lot less quality. I know you can't feel what I'm feeling through the video, but it's not as sturdy. It's a little flimsier. The plastic isn't as thick, and it does have a little bit of a tannish yellow tinge. So I don't know if you guys can see that as well as I can in real life through the camera, but this is perfectly clear, and this one looks like it was either, you know, thrown through the wash, or it's just got that little yellow tint that is another red flag and a huge giveaway that you should walk away from this pop. So if you're buying a pop in person, you definitely want to check out the figure and the box before you walk away and make the purchase. So here we go. We got our two General Grievous figures. Now, right off the bat, you can tell the head coloring is a little different, but more noticeably, look at the real Grievous. He has nice shiny eyes, whereas the fake one, he's got dull little black M&Ms here. So that's a huge giveaway that we got something wrong here. Another thing I wanted to point out, which I don't know if anyone's discussed, but obviously General Grievous, he is a Jedi hunter, nor Sith. Not on the good side, not on the bad side. We'll get into more of that, I'm sure, in future videos. But, you know, he wants to be able to turn his head during a lightsaber battle. And look, he turns his head and he's cutting himself apart. You know, he's knocking into his own lightsabers that he's proudly stolen from other Jedi. So that is a huge red flag. And when you turn his actual head on the real Funko Pop, look at that. Not interfering with any of his lightsabers there, which is very important. Another thing I want to point out is the actual spring underneath the head. As you can see, it's pretty clear and distinct, the one from Funko, and this one that someone made. And once again, kudos to the person that actually made this pop, because they did a really good job. This one is not as large, it's not as elongated, and that's why his head is not nearly as tall as the real Grievous pop. Another thing I want to point out is the fact that the spring is what gives these Star Wars pops their bobble. And it's required by their licensing with Funko. So this one doesn't have as much springiness because the spring is not as long. And because of that, his head is tilted a little off. So there you guys have it. This is a commonly faked pop, unfortunately, because this is the only General Grievous pop that they have ever made. Right now, the PPG for this guy is $90. And the reason I want to start making these videos is because I don't want anyone to get scammed and paying $90 for the only General Grievous pop that they ever made. So we're going to get these guys back in their boxes. We're going to get the real Grievous back in his stack. And I'm going to tell you guys a great place where you can actually go find a great General Grievous pop for your collection. All right, guys. So there you have it. My quick but overall pretty important breakdown of a real versus fake General Grievous pop. Now, when it comes to buying fake pops, please be careful. Always do your research. If you are buying from Mercari, whatnot, eBay, you do have the ability to return a pop after you purchase it if you believe that you have picked up a fake pop. It happens to all of us. We've all done it. Believe me, I've been collecting for 8 years and I found almost half a dozen fake pops in my collection, and it hurts when you realize what you paid for it. So the reason we are making today's video and future videos is to prevent you guys from spending money on pops that aren't real. That is the whole point. We all got to help each other out in the Funko community. And at the end of the day, if you think you are about to buy a fake pop or you're just unsure, just ask. ask somebody who has the pop, go on Instagram, find somebody who has one that looks real, is legit. We are just here to help in the community. And like I said, if you are looking to pick up a General Grievous pop that is 100% authentic, there was a restock last year, and if you do not care about this sticker, because at the end of the day, it's just a sticker. Believe me, I'm a sticker guy, but at the end of the day, a sticker doesn't mean much. Epic Collectibles actually has the General Grievous pop right now for only $65. And I have a feeling once the restock pops have all hit the market, this pop is going to be going up in value once again, because this is the only General Grievous pop they have ever made. I would love to see a updated version of him, maybe with 4 lightsabers instead of 2, or maybe a movie moment where he's battling Obi-Wan Kenobi from the Clone Wars, but one day. Funko owes us a lot of Star Wars fire. We'll see what we get this year. But in the meantime, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Let me know down in the comment section below if there is any other pop you would like me to break down. Even if it's not one I currently own, I will go out and buy it just so I can do a review video for you guys. So that's all I have for you guys. Hopefully you're having a good day. Remember, don't stop shooting until you score, and we'll see you guys very soon.